Michael Bond has had trouble breathing for most of his 52 years. And like many people diagnosed with chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, or COPD, he didn't know what he had or how to treat it.
Honestly, until I came to West Park, I really didn't know much about it. The intern respirologist explained to me that the difference between an asthma attack and the actual COPD, but it was a generalized, a generalized idea.
A study led by Toronto's West Park Healthcare Center that was published in the Canadian Medical Association Journal found that most patients with a debilitating lung disease are not aware of their diagnosis, despite a recent visit to primary care.
What we found, we went to primary care facilities in Toronto, in Ottawa, and in Sault Ste. Marie to try and capture a representative sample of Canadians in urban, suburban, and rural areas. We found that there were a lot of people who were diagnosed positive for COPD who were unaware of their diagnosis. Quite a high percent. We had we found that 21% of the people we tested were positive for COPD. And of those people, 70% were unaware of the diagnosis, and about half continued to smoke.
So what I want you to do is, again, remember...
With COPD on the rise, Dr. Goldstein says the importance of early intervention from family physicians is very important.
Breathing in.
Family physicians probably need to be a little bit more aware that if they have high-risk people in over the age of 40, smoke more than 20 years, they should think about COPD, take a history for COPD, and arrange the simple spirometry test.
Left undiagnosed and untreated, COPD's burden on the patient and the healthcare system can be a heavy one.
If you allow the disease to progress, then there are more hospitalizations, unscheduled visits to the emergency department or to the family physician. These are all expensive. Medications are expensive, and there are societal costs in terms of leisure activities and dropping out of the workforce. So all in all, the burden of the condition is lessened if it's diagnosed and managed earlier.
But for Michael Bond, he's happy the diagnosis came late than never.
The change in my life has just been phenomenal, from walking in here gasping for breath and pain, not being able to walk five steps. I can go out and walk. I can go to a shopping mall and not be terrified that I'm going to collapse. I can maybe go out to dinner with my wife in a restaurant and not be embarrassed about how sick I am. It's so hard to explain the difference it's made. Like you say, I can walk for an hour. Like, gently and carefully, but I can walk. Like, and that's something I haven't done in years. Like, just being able to get out and be a normal human being again, like everybody else, is just phenomenal.